Now let's meet the first team, Laurie Nyveen. What is the official language of Chile?
Spanish.
Right. Lorne Beiles, Peter Ilyich are the first two names of which Russian composer?
Tchaikovsky.
Yes. David Tanenbaum, what number does the Roman numeral CX stand for?
110.
Yes. Kenny Hechtman, birds that probe for insects in tree bark and chisel holes in trees are commonly called what?
Woodpeckers.
What else? This is the team from Bialik High School in Coach St. Luke. And let's meet the other team. Peter Silva, what kind of weapons are referred to as Lugers, Webleys, and Colts?
Pistols.
Yes, we'll take that. David Richardson, name one of the two Canadian provinces that do not border on salt water.
Saskatchewan.
Yes, the other is Alberta. Pam Murray, in which American state would you find the Great Salt Lake?
Utah.
Right. Valerie Frost, which chemical element is represented by the symbol AG?
Argon.
Notice silver. This is the team from Beaconsfield High School. These two high school teams are here to play the fourth game of the third league on Reach for the Top.
Welcome to the game in which some of Quebec's brightest students show their knowledge and power of quick recall as they strive to become the annual Montreal champions on Reach for the Top. Hi, and welcome to our game. I'm Mark Cote. Well, here we are, just past the midpoint in the season, and we are at Game 4 of League 3. We started with four leagues of eight teams each, Bialik and Beaconsfield having it out today. To help us evaluate their answers, we have our judges in studio with us. Here they are, Arnie Greenberg and Jackie Paul. Of course, their decisions are final. Now let's meet the man with all the questions, your quizmaster, Bob Cadman.
Thank you, Mark Cote, and thank you once again, everybody. Well, the teams seem to be trying to outdo one another when it comes to mascots. Bialik brought something different. There it is. That's Bob the Airplane, operated, they tell me, by the Canadian Jewish Airline. If you believe that, you'll believe anything. All right, not to be outdone, down below, Beaconsfield has brought along a beast of a different color. That is Buffy, the Beaconsfield Bison. So it's the bison versus the airplane, and here we go with some news questions for 10 points apiece. Name the only Inuit MP who crossed the House, Pam Murray.
I don't know.
Too much time, Lorne Beiles.
Itinuar.
That's right, Peter Itinuar joined the Liberal Party. A rampage was sparked by what white, Lorne Beiles?
The Ku Klux Klan.
Yes, white supremacist group in Washington. A Norwegian explorer says he has found, Lorne Beiles. Pardon me?
Amhart.
No, found traces of an advanced civilization on a remote Indian Ocean island. Who is that explorer, Beaconsfield? Peter Silva.
Knudsen?
No, Thor Heyerdahl. Who is the new Prime Minister of Japan, Lorne Beiles?
Nakasone.
Judges, close enough. Yoshihiro Nakasone. Name the mass murderer who returned to British, Lorne Beiles?
Olson.
Clifford Olson, yes. And that makes it Bialik 80, Beaconsfield 30. Here's an open question now. I'll ask you to give the name applied to a resident or a native of a certain city. For example, a native of Edmonton is an, that's not the question, is an Edmontonian. Now here we go. A resident of Calgary. Lorne Beiles.
Calgarian.
Yes. Dublin. Peter Silva.
Dublonian.
No. Bialik. David Tanenbaum.
Dublinite.
No, a Dubliner. How about Moscow? Lorne Beiles.
Moscovite.
Muscovite, close enough. Muscovite, thought somebody might say a mosquito, but no. Halifax, David Richardson.
Haligonian.
Yes. Liverpool, Valerie Frost.
Liverpudlian.
You've got it. Scramble for 5 points. On which Canadian coin is a beaver depicted? David Tanenbaum.
Nickel.
A nickel. 40-point team question now for Bialik. 10 points for each right answer about Canadian currency. Whose picture is found on these denominations? A $10 bill. Bialik? Try it, anybody? David Tanenbaum.
McDonald.
Yes, it is. A $1 bill. Don't look in your pocket. David?
Queen Elizabeth.
Yes, a $50 bill. I haven't seen one of those. David?
Ethan Baker.
No, you're not that rich, eh? No, Mackenzie King and a $5 bill. You've seen them. David?
Laurie.
Laurie, it is. And now it is Bialik 135, Beaconsfield 50 points. This may change things. It's a 40-pointer. What year am I? It drops 10 points at each clue I give you. Mrs. Thelma Forbes became the first woman in the Manitoba legislature, while Tom Jones won an Academy Award for Best Picture. What year am I? Anybody? Pam Murray.
1968.
No. Bialik? David Tanenbaum.
74.
No. Second clue. Kenya became an independent nation in Africa, and Queen Elizabeth celebrated her 37th birthday. Lorne Beiles.
73.
No. Beaconsfield? Pam Murray.
75.
No. Third clue. The Toronto Maple Leafs won the Stanley Cup, and the Hamilton Tiger Cats, David Richardson.
1967?
No. Hamilton Tiger Cats defeated British Columbia Lions for the Grey Cup. Bialik's turn, David Tanenbaum.
64.
No. Final clue. Lester Pearson became the 14th Prime Minister, David Richardson.
63.
That is right. 1963 for 10 points. And we have a question about heroines of literature. Identify these heroines whose names are used as the titles of the works they appear in. A penniless orphan left to the care of Peter Silva. He doesn't know. To the Lorne Beiles.
Little Orphan Annie?
No, it is Jane Eyre, one of the Bronte books. A passionate girl in an 1856 novel by Gustave Flaubert. David Tanenbaum.
Madame Bovary?
Yes. The wife of a Russian aristocrat who falls for a dashing cavalry officer, Pam Murray.
Anna Karenina?
That's right, by Tolstoy. The biblical character who gleaned in the fields of the wealthy Boaz in one of the books of the Old Testament. David Tanenbaum.
Rebecca.
No, Beaconsfield, Pam Murray.
Ruth?
It is Ruth, yes. Now we move on to physics. I'll give you part of a formula in physics. You complete it. Energy of a photon divided by frequency equals what? Peter Silva.
Wavelength?
No. Bialik?
Resistance?
Nyveen. Laurie Nyveen.
Resistance?
No, it is H, or Planck's constant. Charge divided by time equals what? They haven't a clue, or have they? Laurie Nyveen.
Work?
No. Beaconsfield? Valerie Frost.
Mass?
No, it is current. And current multiplied by resistance equals what? Resistance.
Friction?
No. Bialik? Time is up. The answer is voltage. And there's the buzzer winding up this part of the show, and it stands now at Bialik 145, Beaconsfield 80. Now we move on to our list question. Each team acting as a team is to make a list of answers to the question I'm going to give you. And you'll have 45 seconds, teams, during the break to make your list. Then the judges will collect a copy of it so you can't change it after that. Here's the list question. I want you to list the five teams of the Smythe Division of the National Hockey League. Each team will get 5 points for each correct answer. Both teams could get them all right. And to find out what their answers are, we'll be back in a minute from now. Don't go away.
Groucho Marx, Chico, Harpo, John Wayne, Laurel and Hardy, Carol Channing, and Peter Sellers. Rich Little's Robin Hood, a super show tonight.
I think we can all be reasonable about this.
Keep your nickels, Monroe.
Strikes rock the Monroe Empire, and Jimmy finds himself in trouble.
Why won't you listen to me?
I say you can run that company.
I'm making a mess of the job.
Are you going to stand there and tell me that you can't do it?
Empire, tonight on CBC Television.
Real king and queen before.
Tonight, Wembley learns who his friends are.
They are gourds. They want to make slaves of us.
Fraggle Rock tonight. Anka on CBC Television, one of the great entertainers of our time. Superstar guests. What a show. Paul Anka. Anka. Monday night on CBC Television.
That guy ought to be a
Now we'll call on spokesmen for each team to give the lists they've made up. For Bialik, David Tanenbaum.
Yeah. Boston, Atlanta, Islanders, Philadelphia, Pittsburgh.
And Beaconsfield, David Richardson, give me your list.
The Los Angeles Kings, the Edmonton Oilers, the Vancouver Canucks, the Winnipeg Jets, and the Calgary Flames.
And the correct answers are Edmonton, Los Angeles, Vancouver, Winnipeg, and Calgary. Judges, what points do they get on that? How about that? Bialik got no score on that. Beaconsfield got them all right for 25 points. And that makes it Bialik 145. Beaconsfield is catching up. Beaconsfield is 105. Now we go on to sights and sounds. So watch your screen at home and the big screen here in the studio, and you're going to see motion picture actors. Tell me who they are. Yes, David Tanenbaum. Too much time. Let's know when you ring. Pam Murray.
Donald Sutherland.
Indeed. Who is this? David.
Burt Reynolds.
Yes. And this actor, David Tanenbaum.
Sylvester Stallone.
That is right. No prompting for the audience. Now, how about this, David?
Caan.
All right, James Caan. Here we go again. David Tanenbaum.
McQueen.
Steve McQueen. And who is that, David?
Schwarzenegger.
No, it's not. Beaconsfield, David Richardson.
Marlon Brando.
No, it was Charles Bronson. We're going to play some pop music for you now. Identify these groups or vocalists on these numbers.
You made a fool of me.
Lorne Beiles.
Queen?
No. Valerie Frost.
ELO.
That's right. Electric Light Orchestra, Evil Woman. Who's this?
Heard it from a friend.
Pam Murray.
R.E.S. Speedwagon.
Yes, Take It on the Run. You knew that one. See if you know this. David Tanenbaum.
Survivor.
Nope. Memory.
Chilliwack.
No, it's the Little River Band and Man on the Run. One more coming up. Lorne Beiles.
No.
He doesn't know. Memory.
Journey.
Journey. Any way you want it. And look at that score now. Bialik 185, Beaconsfield 145. Just a 40-point margin, not too much. Try you on art now. Tell me the artist who painted these 20th-century Canadian works. This is by an artist born in Brantford, Ontario in 1885, David Tanenbaum.
Jackson.
No, he became one of Canada's most famous artists, Beaconsfield, Pam Murray.
Thompson.
No, it's Lauren Harris. This work was painted in 1921 and is now David Tanenbaum.
McDonald.
Yes, J.E.H. McDonald. This artist was never a member, but David Tanenbaum?
Carr.
Emily Carr, Big Raven, and now a member of the original, David Tanenbaum. Too much time. The original group of seven, Beaconsfield, David
Jackson.
Pardon?
Jackson.
A.Y. Jackson, the Red Maple, you are right. And we have some road signs we're going to show you on the screen. Tell me what each one of them means. Here it comes. David Tanenbaum.
Yield.
Yield, indeed. What's this one, David?
Left turn only, right turn.
No, no. Peter Silva?
Right turn.
Necessary. Right turn, yes. How about this one, David Tanenbaum?
Slippery Road.
No. Beaconsfield, Valerie Frost?
Windy Road.
Winding Road. Here's another sign, Lorne Beiles.
Four-way stop signs.
No, it's not. Beaconsfield, Pam Murray.
Four-way intersection?
Judges, no. It's a traffic circle, a rotary. What about this one? Yes, David?
Shortening the to one lane.
No. Peter Silva?
Merge, like smaller road.
No, the road narrows is the meaning. And we have one more there, Lorne Beiles.
Narrow Bridge.
Narrow Bridge, that's right. That's the end of our sights and sounds. And it's Bialik 225, Beaconsfield 175.
Let me just slip in quickly here while there's a break in the action and tell you about the prizes. First of all, to all of our contestants, we award the special Reach for the Top pin. Bronze for the first round. Silver for league winners, and gold for the annual Montreal champions. As well, to the winning school will go a $1,000 scholarship, possession of the CBC trophy, that's it here, for 1 year, and the right to represent the province of Quebec at the national finals of Reach for the Top, which will be played this year in Toronto. And there's a prize, too, for the runner-up team on the season. Second place gets $500. Now let's get back to the action. Once again, here's Bob Catman.
Yes, our competition between Bob the Airplane and Buffy the Bison, or at least those are the mascots. And we have some assigned questions for you right now. Eight of them, one for each of the students on the show. If the first student who tries it can't get it, it goes to the member of the other team right above or right below. I want you to tell me the capitals of each of these countries. For you, Laurie Nyveen, Afghanistan.
Kabul.
Yes. Lorne Beiles, Venezuela.
Caracas.
Yes. David Tanenbaum, Algeria.
Tangiers.
No. Pam Murray?
I don't know.
Algiers. Kenny Hechtman, Austria.
Vienna.
Indeed. And we have some countries and capitals for the other team. Beaconsfield, Peter Silva, Cyprus.
Minerals.
He doesn't know. Laurie Nyveen?
Cypriot City?
No, it's Nicosia. David Richardson, Bulgaria.
Budapest?
No, Lorne Beiles.
Sophia.
Right. Pam Murray, Kenya.
I don't know.
David Tanenbaum?
Nairobi.
Right. Valerie Frost, Ecuador. Kenny Hechtman?
Quito.
Quito, yes, that's right. And that makes it Bialik 270, Beaconsfield 175. Another set of news questions here for 10 points each. Name the Canadian on trial in Britain for spying, Pam Murray.
Hamilton.
Hugh Hamilton, yes. The jury was told that Hamilton had dinner with the then David Richardson.
And Dropoff.
Yes, he was then head of the KGB. It was said that Hamilton leaked some top secret, Lorne Bailey.
NATO documents.
Not what we want. Some top secret documents. What was the official classification given these documents? Beaconsfield's turn.
Oh, sorry.
Anyone know that? All right, Pam Murray.
Top secret.
No, they were even higher than that. They were called cosmic. Wow. Prime Minister Margaret Thatcher received a letter bomb, Lorne Bailes.
From an animal group. Protection.
Judges? No. A letter bomb in the mail. Pamper.
Animal rights militia.
That's it. Name the Canadian, a former 100-meter champion who died recently. Time is up. That is Percy Williams. And we have a score of Bialik 270, Beaconsfield 205. Now we have a white question for you. All the answers have to contain the word white. Which portion of the SCTV program has developed its own Pam Murray?
The Great White North.
Yes. What television show about basketball with white in the title, David Tanenbaum?
White Shadow.
Yes. What structure is located, David Tanenbaum?
White House.
The White House. Give me both the first and last name of the author who wrote the children's classic Charlotte's Web. Peter Silva.
E.B. White.
No, Bialik, David Tanenbaum.
E.B. White.
No, it's Theodore White. What is the name of Vancouver's soccer team? David Richardson.
The Whitecaps?
Yes, it is. Scramble for 5 points. Who was the scientist who originated the theory that states, if for all frames of reference, the speed of light is constant, and if all, Peter
Einstein?
Silva. Einstein is right. So a 40-point team question now goes to Beaconsfield. 10 points for each right answer about the life and work of Albert Einstein. What is the formula expressing that theory which made possible the construction of the atomic bomb, Beaconsfield, Pam Murray?
E equals MC squared.
Yes. Albert Einstein was born on March 14, 1879, in the city of Ulm, in what country?
France.
What country? David.
France?
No, it was Germany. Name one of the two countries Einstein became a citizen of, Pam.
United States.
Yes, the other was Switzerland. Somebody else spoke after the bell rang, so that counts as a consultation. No points on that. At which university did Einstein spend the majority of his later years seeking a single mathematical expression of the relation between electromagnetism and gravitation? What university, Peter Silva?
MIT.
No, it was Princeton. And now the score is Bialik 290, Beaconsfield 240. We're going to move on now to an open question about the French Revolution. What name do historians give the period of bloodshed that followed the execution of Louis XVI, lasting from 1793 to 94? Anybody? David Tanenbaum.
The Bloody Years.
No, Beaconsfield. No, that was the Reign of Terror. What was the name of the radical political society whose rise to power in 1793 initiated the Reign of Terror? Laurie, Nyveen.
The First Republic.
No, Beaconsfield. Peter Silva.
National Republicans.
No, the answer is the Jacobins. A famous scene from the Reign of Terror climaxes which novel of the French Revolution by Charles Valery Frost?
A Tale of Two Cities.
That is right, by Charles Dickens. Chemistry now. What is the neutral crystalline product of an acid-base reaction called, David Tanenbaum?
Salt.
Yes. What is the other product of such a reaction, Peter Silva?
Neutralized solution.
No, Bialik, Laurie Nyveen.
Water.
It is water. What acid and what strong base react to produce common table salt and water? Or anything.
Hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide.
That is right. What is the common name of the salt obtained from the reaction of potassium hydroxide with nitric acid? Lauren Evin.
Potassium nitrate.
Judges? No, Beaconsfield. Emory.
Table salt.
No, we want the common name. It is saltpeter, which is potassium nitrate. We wanted the common name, though. And we have a score of 320 for Bialik, 250 for Beaconsfield. And now scramble for 5 points. What general of the Confederate forces in the American Civil War surrendered to General Grant at David Richardson?
Lee.
General Robert E. Lee, yes. And this deals with Lee and his campaign gains for 30 points Beaconsfield. Lee's closest associate in his first battles was the leader of Confederate campaigns in the Shenandoah Valley, noted for his strength of will and firmness under fire. Who was he, Peter Silva?
Stonewall Jackson?
Yes. At which battle in July 1863 was Lee defeated by Northern forces, Peter?
Gettysburg?
Yes. Lee's army made its final retreat in 1865 after the fall of the capital of the Confederacy. What was the capital, Peter Silva?
Atlanta?
No, it was Richmond. And peninsulas now, geography. Which two European countries are situated on the Iberian Peninsula?
Spain and Portugal.
Yes. What narrow point of land in Turkey? And there's the buzzer winding up this part of the show. And look at that score. Bialik 320, Beaconsfield 285. So there's a 35-point margin separating the two teams. A lot more points than that coming up in the short snappers. Either team can win. Don't go away. We'll be right back.
When the average baby is born, he or she gets a heart that's good for around 2.5 billion heartbeats. Give or take a few hundred million. You can use them up fast, or you can use them up slowly. The heart is a muscle, and a muscle needs exercise to stay fit. The more you exercise it, the healthier it gets, and the slower it beats overall. The less you exercise it, the more out of shape it gets, the harder it has to work, the faster it beats.
Of course, we'll all end up here sooner or later, but wouldn't you rather it be later than sooner?
A message on health from the Quebec Society for Crippled Children.
Remember the old days, Chester?
The dancing, the fun, the people.
You could have people again if you were restored.
I'm useless.
You're part of our built heritage.
Who needs it?
People do. People need roots, communities, families, and you are part of the family.
I belong?
To all of us.
Keep heritage in the family.
Join the Heritage Canada Foundation.
The SM 5000 Classical Recording Series.
Half-speed mastering and...
digital recordings. Listen to us and feel the music.
Wednesday on Portraits. Veronica Tennant, a dancer of distinction. Her work, her art.
The ones that I enjoy the most are the dramatic ballets. So, in a sense, I sometimes think of myself as a dance actress.
Wednesday on CBC Television.
The judges are taking 10 points off the Beaconsfield's team because they consulted after the bell was rung on the Gettysburg question, so sorry we can't give any points on that. Now the short snappers. What actor played Little Joe in the television series Davidson?
Michael Landon?
No. Yes, that's right. We'll take it. What is the name of the boat on which Henry Hudson explored Hudson Bay and James Bay, David?
Half Moon.
No, Beaconsfield? It was the Discovery. What nationality was the magician Harry Houdini born David Tanenbaum?
German.
No, born Eric Weiss. Peter Silva.
Italian?
No, Hungarian, later American. Who wrote the play The Caucasian Chalk Circle? That is Bertolt Brecht. In which decade was Tutankhamun's tomb discovered, Peter Silva?
20th. Oh, 1920s.
We can't take it, Bialik. Kenny Hechtman.
1920s.
That's right. What kind of leaves form the most important part of a koala's diet? David Hennebaum.
Eucalyptus.
Yes. How many points were laid down by U.S. President Wilson as conditions, Lorne, Nyveen?
14.
14 points. Who was the first Prime Minister of the Republic of India? Lorne Beiles.
Nehru.
Yes. What cigar-shaped island in the mouth of the St. Lawrence was until 1975?
Anticosti.
Silva? Pardon?
Anticosti.
Yes. What instrument is used for measuring the speed of wind? David Hennebaum.
Velometer.
No. Mixfield. Peter Silva.
Anemometer.
Yes. Vilnius is the capital of which republic of the USSR, Lorne Beiles?
Lithuania.
Yes. In 1982, 5 million enumerators undertook the largest census ever in what, Peter Silva?
China.
Yes, that's right. What is the term for the study of flora? Lorne Beiles?
Florist,
though. No, Beaconsfield, Peter Silva?
Botany.
Botany. On what New York Avenue is the traditional Easter, David Tanenbaum?
That would be Fifth Avenue.
Fifth Avenue. What is a copse, David Tanenbaum?
It's a policeman.
No, it's not. Beaconsfield, it is a thick, ever-dense bush, And the bell is gone, and the game is over. And the final score, Bialik 380, Beaconsfield 325. The winner, Bialik High School from Coach St. Luke. And our congratulations to the team from Bialik High, Laurie Nyveen, Lorne Beiles, David Tanenbaum, and Kenny Hechtman, and your team counselors, Mr. David Cape, Mr. Brian Wolofsky, Mr. Brian Katchen, and Mr. Harvey Levinson. Well, that was a very, very close game, as you could see. They're both very strong teams. I wish we could bring you both back. You both did so well. Thank you, Beaconsfield. Let's have a good hand for them. So now we've declared our four first-round winners in this third league. We'll be seeing some of them again next week. Don't miss it as we have another exciting game. I'm Bob Cadman. So long till then. Mark Cote, it's all yours.
All right, so now we say to you, Bialik, congratulations. You're one step closer to the top. We'll see you in 2 weeks when you come by to take on the winner of next week's game. Next week, we look forward to meeting again the people from Outremont and Malcolm Campbell High Schools. Reach for the Top is brought to you by the CBC and is designed as a showcase for outstanding Canadian students. I'm Mark Cote, inviting you to be with us again in 7 days when more students meet to compete on Reach for the Top. Most of the questions used on Reach for the Top are checked in the Encyclopedia Britannica. From Studio 42 in Maisonneuve-Latour, Canada, CBC proudly brings you the 1982-83 edition of Reach for the Top. Let's meet our competitors with a quick round of assigned questions.
And let's meet the first team. Peter Asimakopoulos, which saint's name has been given to a breed of dog used in the Alps and two mountain passes?
Saint Bernard.
Right. Tom Demichin, what does the acronym ICBM stand for? Intercontinental Ballistic Missile. David Eng, whom do we honor for the invention of wireless telegraphy?
Marconi.
Right. John Andrianus, to which political party did Prime Minister Arthur Meehan belong?
PC.
That is right. And this is the team from Outremont High School. Let's meet the other team, Holden Huey. In Canada and the U.S., how many million dollars does it take to make 1 billion?
Two.
No, it takes 1,000 million. Gerry Moschopoulos, who is the actor who played the male lead in the film Casablanca?
Humphrey Bogart.
Right. Victor Sandor, what is the name of the New York team that plays in the North American Soccer League?
The Sting.
Notice the Cosmos. Stephen Siamidis, which 15th century saint is said to have heard the voices of St. Catherine, St. Margaret, and St. Michael?
Joan of Arc.
That is right. This is the team from Malcolm Campbell High School in Montreal. These two high school teams are here to play the first semifinal game of the third league on Reach for the Top.
Welcome to the game in which some of Quebec's brightest students show their knowledge and power of quick recall as they strive to become the annual Montreal champions on Reach for the Top. Hello, welcome to our game. I'm Mark Cote. Well, we're into the kind of finals, if you will. These are the semifinals of this third league, and we're seeing Outremont and Malcolm Campbell High Schools for the second time. We're looking forward to an exciting game. To help evaluate the answers, we have in studio with us our two judges. Both are CSHEP teachers. Here they are, Arnie Greenberg and Jackie Paul. And, of course, their decisions are final. Now, let's meet the man with all the questions. Your quiz master, Bob Cadman.
Thank you, Mark Cote. Thank you, everybody. What enthusiasm we've got here today. We've got cheerleaders and horns there in the audience. I think I'm going to suffer from terminal deafness. And we have two good teams, I want to tell you. Let's see how they're doing some news questions. 10 points apiece. What was Professor Hugh Hambleton's sentence? Tom DeVeachin.
He was sentenced 10 years.
That is right. Marc Baudouin and Jocelyn Ménard will share what duties previously held by Mayor Jean Drapeau. Tom DeVeachin.
Chairman of the council.
Montreal council meetings. Reggie Smith is leaving the Gerry Moschopoulos.
He's going to Tokyo, Japan.
Yes, he's going to play for the Tokyo Giants instead of the San Francisco Giants. Name the former leader of what is now Zimbabwe, who's Gerry Moschopoulos.
Ian Smith.
Phil Edmonston of the Automobile Protection Association reversed. John Andrianis.
Approved the LADA.
That is right. He reversed his decision about the LADA. And that makes the Outremont 60, Malcolm Campbell 40. Now we're going back into the early days of North American history to hear about some historical occupations. I'm going to ask you to identify some of the jobs and occupations from those early times. What was the name for the man who manufactured casks and barrels? Yes, Gerry Moschopoulos.
A cooper.
What kind of worker processed animal hides? One of the, Gerry.
A taxidermist?
No, one of the preparatory stages in the manufacture of leather. Outremont, David Eng.
Tanner.
Pardon me?
Tanner.
A tanner is right. Finally, what was the name for the man who mended pots, kettles, pans, and similar to Victor Sandor?
Blacksmith?
No, similar pioneer appliances, Outremont? Try it. Anybody there? Peter Assimacopoulos?
Blacksmith?
No, it was a tinker. And we have a scramble here for 5 points. What well-known racing driver was killed on May 8th, Tom DeMeechan?
Gilles Villeneuve,
1982. And this question for Outremont is about the career of Gilles Villeneuve. 40 points possible. He was killed while qualifying for what Grand Prix race? Tom DeMeechan.
The Belgian Grand Prix.
Yes. A former world champion and ex-teammate of Villeneuve said of the Canadian racer, he was the fastest racing driver who ever lived. Who was the South African driver who said that? For you, Outremont team question. Time's running out. Must tell you, it is Jody Scheckter. In addition to automobile racing, Villeneuve had enormous success in another area of competitive racing. In what sport did he win 2 Canadian championships and a world title? Outremont, have a try. Tom DeMeechan.
Atlantic car racing.
No, it was snowmobile racing. Villeneuve made his Grand Prix racing debut in 1977, starting 3 races before being installed as a regular on what racing team in 1978, Tom?
Ferrari.
Yes, indeed. And the score now, Outremont 95, Malcolm Campbell 50. Let's see how you do on mathematics here, an open question. Give one of the 2 possible values of x in the following quadratic equations. X squared minus 121 equals 0. There it is on the screen. Gerry Moschopoulos.
Plus negative 11.
Yes. And on the screen again, you will see X squared plus 4X plus, Gerry Moschopoulos.
X is minus 3 and minus 1.
Minus 3 is correct, yes, or minus 1. 2X squared plus 7X plus 3 equals 0. All
plus
right,
one.
Victor Sander, pardon me?
Plus 1 and 6.
No, it's not. Outremont? That's a harder one. Well, time is up. Minus 3 and minus 1/2. And finally, x squared minus 7x plus 12 equals nothing. Gerry Moschopoulos.
6 and 1.
No. Outremont? Peter Assimacopoulos.
Minus 3 minus 4.
No, it's plus 4 and plus 3. So that score is very close. Outremont 95, Malcolm Campbell 70. We're going up in the sky now for an astronomy question. Which planet has a moon called Deimos? Gerry Moschopoulos.
Mars.
What constellation has 6 bright stars in his sword and belt? Holden Huey.
Orion.
Right. At present, which planet is farthest from the sun? Tom DeMeechan.
Neptune.
It is Neptune now, not Pluto. Pluto has an eccentric orbit. Pluto is normally farthest from the sun, but right now it is closer than Neptune. And name 2 of the 3 planets now known to have rings. Gerry Moschopoulos.
Jupiter and Saturn.
That is right. The other one is Uranus. Look at that now. Ultramel 105, Malcolm Campbell 100. Going back to the past now, statesmen from years gone by, tell me the country in which each of these men held positions of importance. William Pitt, Gerry Moschopoulos.
England.
Yes. William Seward, Gerry Moschopoulos.
The United States.
Yes. Charles de Tal... Gerry Moschopoulos.
France.
France. Talleyrand. Kwame Nkrumah. That's a harder one. Stephen Symonis.
Germany.
No. Outremont. Tom DeMeechan.
Belgium.
No, it is Ghana. And there's the buzzer winding up this part of our program, and the score stands at Malcolm Campbell 130, Outremont 105. Now, before we take a break and go on to sights and sounds, we'll have the list question. I want each school acting as a team to write down a list of the answers to the question I'll give you. You've got 45 seconds during the break to make your list, then the judges will collect a copy of the answers so you can't change them after time is up. Here is the list question. List the six noble or inert gases. 5 points for each right answer. Either team can have correct answers, and we'll be back with their list and with sights and sounds right after this.
What do you mean there's no water? Bang the pipe!
When the Fraggle well runs dry, Gobo's on a mission for a sacred banging stick. Fraggle Rock Sunday. Join us Sunday for Super Comedy with Wayne and...
Tuesday. Oh,
yeah. Johnny and Frank and their version of a great moment in history.
Hail Menelaus.
Hail Agamemnon.
Super Comedy Sunday on CBC Television.
Well, is this a Canadian story?
It is.
In the field of entertainment?
Yes.
Ready?
Are we talking about a television program?
We are.
Is it a program on CBC?
Yes.
On Sunday nights?
Yes.
At 8:30, 9 o'clock in Newfoundland?
Yes.
Then it's going to be Front Page Challenge.
That's it. Good going, Colonel.
Front Page Challenge.
You pathetic old fool. I've put up with your indifference, your obsession with your empire, but I will not be humiliated.
Empire Sunday.
We're back, and time to hear what kind of a list the teams came up with. Outremont, here's Tom DeMeechan to give us their answers.
Neon, argon, xenon, krypton, radon, and helium.
And Gerry Moschopoulos from Malcolm Campbell, your list.
Krypton, argon, xenon, neon, radon, helium.
They sounded pretty good. The right answer is just to check them. Helium, neon, argon, krypton, xenon, and radon. And I'll check with the judges to see the scores. It's perfect. 30 points for both teams. That makes it Outremont 135, Malcolm Campbell 160. Now we go on to sights and sounds. Identify these politicians of yesteryear. Who is this on your screen? Tom DeMeechan.
Pearson.
Lester Pearson. And this statesman, Tom.
Mackenzie.
No, Malcolcolm Campbell, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Louis Saint Laurent.
Right. Who is this gentleman? Gerry?
Ethan Baker.
Yes. Who is this? I can't take that, Uranus, before it came up. We'll give it to Malcolm Campbell. Has a turn, Stephen Symonis?
The Shah.
More specific?
Of Iran.
Right. Who is this? Jeremy Shabalos?
Tito.
Marshal Tito of Yugoslavia. One more there, Jeremy Shabalos?
Sadat.
Anwar Sadat, that's good. And we have a score now of 210 for Malcolm Campbell. Outremont 145. We're going to play you some music from Broadway shows here. Themes and songs from various productions. Tell me what show these came from. Listen carefully. Jeremy Shabalos.
Annie.
Annie, the song is Tomorrow. What show this time? Victor Sandor.
Fiddler on the Roof.
Fiddler on the Roof, If I Were a Rich Man. Here we go again. David Ng?
Oklahoma.
No, it's not. Gerry Moschopoulos.
That's that story?
No, that's harder. That's from Evita about Eva Perón, and it's called Don't Cry for Me, Argentina. One more. Gerry Moschopoulos.
A chorus line?
No. Yes, it is. A chorus line, and the number is one. Art is our next subject. Identify the Canadian artists who painted these works. I'll give you clues. This is by a group of seven member, David Eng.
Lorne Harris.
Lorne Harris, Mountains and Lake. Now, a native artist, David Eng.
Emily Carr.
No, it's not. Malcolm Campbell, Gerry Moschopoulos.
David Mill.
That's very, very hard. Benjamin Chi-Chi. And here we go again, an established painter. Yes, Gerry Moschopoulos.
A.Y. Jackson.
No. British Columbia is his home, Outremont. David Eng.
Thompson.
No, Jack Shadbolt. And now a painting by the forerunner of the group of seven, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Thompson.
Tom Thompson, Autumn Birches, yes. It is Malcolm Campbell, 250, Outremont, 155. And now we want you to listen carefully. We're going to play some spoken word pieces. Tell me the authors of these pieces of light-hearted poetry or prose. Here we go.
Dear Cousin Nancy, you probably never heard of me or Cousin Beauregard or Cousin Yancey, but since you're claiming kin all the way across the ocean, we figure you must be at least partwise southern. So we consider you not only our kith and kin.
Well, that's Alec Guinness reading Serviette in a Lovely Home, written by what American humorist in 1956? Jerry Moschopoulos?
I don't know.
He doesn't know Outremont? David Eng.
Parker.
No, Ogden Nash. Weird, that was. Here we go again.
The time has come, the walrus said, to talk of many things.
Victor Sandor.
Lewis Carroll.
Lewis Carroll, The Walrus and the Carpenter, read by Peter Ustinov. Who wrote this?
I can remember. The months of November and December were filled for me with peculiar joys, so different from those of other boys.
But other boys. That's the author reading his own poem, The Boy Actor. He himself is an actor, composer, and playwright. Who is he?
While they were taken to pantomime.
No prompting from the audience. Conversation.
Tennessee Williams.
No.
Their children's dances and Christmas trees.
Well, I have to tell you, time is up. That was Noel Coward reading from The Boy Actor, and one more.
George, who played with a dangerous toy and suffered a catastrophe of considerable dimensions. When George's grandmama was told that George had been as good as girls...
That's Peter Ustinov again reading George from Cautionary Tales, written by what British author born in France? Tom Dobichin.
Chaucer.
No, Malcolm Campbell.
And being of a dangerous sort exploded with a loud report.
Have to call time. That's very hard. Hilaire Belloc. And now, finally, in Sights and Sounds, we're going to look through a microscope. You're going to see objects, organisms, or processes as seen through a microscope. Identify them. Here's the first one. Yes, David Eng?
No.
He doesn't know. Victor Sandor?
Fertilization of an egg?
No, it's a slice of bone. What about this object, if it is an object? Peter Simgopoulos?
A white blood cell.
Judges? No. Malcolm Campbell, Victor Sandor.
Phagocytic cell.
It's a monocyte.
No, it is actually blood, not a specific cell. What about this one? What is that, Victor Sandor?
An amoeba.
Right. And here's something else to identify, Peter Simgopoulos.
Paramecium.
Right. This is a process, really. An organic process, Peter.
Mitosis.
Yes. And finally, what are those fellows? Yes, David Eng.
Bacteria.
They are bacteria. And it is now... Outremont, 185, Malcolm Campbell, 270. Oh, well, there's a bit of a break in the action. Let me tell you about prizes. To all of our competitors, we award the special reach for the top pin. Bronze for the first round, silver for league winners, gold for the annual Montreal champions. As well, to the winning school will go a $1,000 scholarship, possession of the CBC trophy for 1 year, and the right to represent the province of Quebec at the national finals of Reach for the Top, which will be played this year in Toronto. And to the runner-up team on the season goes a $500 prize. Now let's go back to the action once again, Bob Cadman. Oh, that's a great gang there. Malcolm Campbell has the lead, but not an insuperable one. We have some more news questions for you. Why was Dr. William DeVries of Salt Lake City, Jeremy Chopoulos?
Because he performed the first surgery for artificial heart.
That's right. Name the man who received Victor Sandor.
Barney Clark.
Barney Clark received the heart. What brought Howard Cosell into the news, Jeremy Chopoulos?
He's not announcing pro boxing anymore.
That's right. He said, I don't want to be a party to the hypocrisy and the sleaziness. All right, President Reagan visited João, David Eng.
Brazil.
Brazil, João Figueiredo, President of Brazil. What did Edward Kennedy announce, Peter Simpopoulos?
That he's not going to be a President of Canada in 1984.
You are right. What year am I now? A 40-pointer, dropping 10 points for each clue I give you. Each team has one chance per clue. In this year, Argentinian President Juan Perón was overthrown by an uprising, Gerry Moschopoulos.
1923?
No. Marty was named the best picture. Winston Churchill was succeeded by Anthony Eden as British Prime Minister. Utramal, your turn. Tom DeMeechan.
1952.
No. Second clue. Jonas Salk discovered an anti-polio, Gerry Moschopoulos.
1955.
Again, please.
1955.
That is right, for 30 points. 30 points there on that one, and we have Roman mythology now. According to Roman legend, which two brothers are credited, David Ng?
Romulus and Remus.
Yes, they founded the city of Rome, it is said. Romulus and Remus were believed to be the sons of the mortal Gerry Moschopoulos.
They were brought up by a wolf.
Not what we want. Sons of the mortal woman Rhea Silvia and a Roman god. What god was their father, Utremont? David Ng?
Saturn.
No, it was Mars. The two future heroes were abandoned in infancy. Gerry Moschopoulos.
They were brought up by a wolf.
Not what we want. They were set adrift in a basket on what Italian river, Utremont? What river? Yes, David?
Tiber.
The Tiber, yes. And what kind of animal discovered, Gerry Moschopoulos?
A wolf.
You got it, finally. Yes, you get your points, but you had to wait for it. Okay, Malcolm Campbell, 340, Utremont, 225. Can't give you the points till the question comes up. Scramble for 5 points. In what organ of the body would you find the tympanic membrane, Vic Sandor?
The ear.
That is good, yes. 30-point team question now for Malcolm Campbell, 10 apiece, all about the ear. What is the more common name given to the tympanic membrane, Vic Sandor?
The eardrum.
Yes. Three tiny bones form the chain across the middle ear. The anvil and the stirrup are two. What's the third, Vic Sandor?
The hammer.
Yes. The auditory nerve connects the brain to what spiral passage? Victor.
Cochlea.
You know all about ears, don't you? Yes. Our subject now is the American Midwest. An American folk song honors the valley region that spreads south from Manitoba into North Dakota and Minnesota. What river valley is this, anyone? John Andrea.
Missouri?
No. Malcolm Campbell, Jeremy Shovelis.
Red River.
The Red River Valley, yes. To encourage German investment in the area in the 1870s, the capital city of North Dakota was named after what, Jeremy Shovelis?
Bismarck.
Bismarck. What U.S. National Memorial is located near Rapid City in the Black Hills of South Dakota? Well known. Peter Singhobaldus.
Memorial to Crazy Horse?
No. Malcolm Campbell? Have to tell you, that's Mount Rushmore. Also in South Dakota is a geographical region eroded into deep gullies and unusual rock formations. Tom DeMeechan.
Grand Canyon.
No. What name is given to this type of region commonly found in the American Midwest? Malcolm Campbell, Victor Sandor.
Gorge.
No, they're called Badlands. And what major river of the Midwest passes through both Dakotas and forms the boundary between Nebraska and Iowa? Gerry.
Mississippi.
No, it's not. Utremont. John Andrian.
Missouri.
It is the Missouri River, that's right. Let's try you on some spelling now. We haven't done this for a long time. I want you to spell the names for these parts of the body. We've already mentioned, I think, the Eustachian tube. Spell Eustachian. Peter Sokopoulos.
Eustachian.
You've got it. The first portion of the small intestine is called the duodenum. Spell that, Peter.
D-O-U.
I'll stop you there. No, Malcolm Campbell. Malcolm Campbell, Victor Sandor.
D-U-O-D-E-N-U-M.
That's it. Any of the bones of the... Nope, there's the buzzer winding up this part of the show, and the score now stands at Malcolm Campbell, 405, Utremont, 245. Malcolm Campbell is still in the lead, but it's not over yet. We've got the short snappers coming right up. We'll be right back. Don't go away.
This winter, CBC Television opens up a whole new world of exciting entertainment, and it's a world you'll want to explore. Be here for the premiere of powerful new dramatic series. Don't miss great theater in exclusive engagement on CBC. Enjoy the finest Canadian and international performers in a whole range of original comedy and music specials. See new and familiar faces bringing you the best in entertainment television. Tune in, the complete information service that provides a uniquely Canadian window on the world. Watch gripping docudramas that bring you the human stories behind the headlines. See first-run movies. Special event coverage, live from around the world. From comedy to drama, music to science and beyond. Watch CBC Television. There's a world of difference.
Look, Watson, the culprit's footprints.
An average sort of footprint, Holmes.
Exactly, Watson. And the solution to the crime.
What?
You are a man of a hearty 90 kilograms, are you not?
But even...
I, a lithe 70 kilograms.
Yes, but...
These footprints are not so deep as yours, Watson, but considerably deeper than mine. I'd put a man at 78 kilograms. You, Carstairs!
Amazing, Holmes.
Metric, Watson.
CBC News reviews the headline stories of the week on Sunday Report. I'm Peter Mansbridge. Join me every Sunday here on CBC Television. We take a second look at the week's top stories with the reporters who covered them. Together, we reflect on the coverage and draw some conclusions about what lies ahead. Now, CBC News Sunday Report at 5 o'clock, 5:30 in Newfoundland on CBC Television.
Here we go with the short snappers, 10 points apiece. What constellation contains the stars Castor and Pollux? Gerry Moschopoulos.
Orion.
He doesn't know. Outremont's turn, please. Time is up. That is Gemini. What migrant bird was hunted to extinction in the U.S.? Gerry Moschopoulos.
The carrier pigeon.
No. Outremont? David Eng.
The passenger pigeon.
The passenger pigeon. What Quebec-born cardinal gave up his position? Gerry Moschopoulos.
Nietzsche.
Yes. Who wrote the play The Rose Tattoo? Gerry Moschopoulos.
Miller.
He doesn't know. Outremont's turn. David Eng.
Tennessee Williams.
Yes. What name is given to the five tendons located at the back of the knee? Tom Mitchin.
The ligaments.
No. Malcolm Campbell. Time is up. That's the hamstrings. What composer's first ballet was entitled The Firebird? Jerry.
Stravinsky.
Yes. Who played the male lead on CBC television in A Gift to Last? Jerry Moschopoulos.
Gordon Pinsent.
Right. And the belief in the correspondence between the shape of the head and a person's mental faculties is called what? Jerry Moschopoulos.
Phrenology.
Again?
Phrenology.
That's it. To what purpose were press gangs used before 1850? All right, John Andrianos.
To hire for the Navy.
Yes, that's it. In what Eastern European country is the zloty, the unit of currency, David Eng?
Poland.
Right. What was the name of the queen who ruled the Netherlands from 18... Jerry Moschopoulos.
Wilhelmina.
Yes. What ancient city in Asia Minor was also known as Ilium, Jerry Moschopoulos?
Troy.
Yes. How many sides and angles does a polygon called, Jerry Moschopoulos?
Three.
No, a polygon called a quindecagon have, Outremont, David Eng?
15.
Who composed the Siegfried Idol as a present for his wife on the birth of their son? That's hard. Time is up. Richard Wagner. Alberta's oil-rich tar sands stretched for more than 160 kilometers along what river? Tom Leachin.
The Red River.
No, Malcolm Campbell. Holden Huey.
Athabasca.
Athabasca. What actor played? There's the bell, and the game is over. And the final score, Malcolm Campbell, 475, Outremont, 295. The winner, Malcolm Campbell High School from Montreal. Good job, Malcolm Campbell. 475 is a very good score. Congratulations to all of the team members. Holden Huey. Gerry Moschopoulos. Victor Sandor. And Stephen Siamidis. And your team counselors, Mr. Philip Spink and Mr. Gary Eng. Well, as I said at the start, they're both strong teams, and Outremont proved that, too. You did very well against Malcolm Campbell. Let's have a great hand now for Outremont High School. So that's one of our semifinalists declared in this third league. We'll have another exciting game for you next week at this time. Don't miss it. I'm Bob Cadman. So long for now. Mark Cote, it's all yours.
All right, so congratulations to you, Malcolm Campbell. You go one step closer to the top. Well, with initials like that, what do you expect? We'll see you in a couple of weeks when you come back to play next week's winner. And next week, we're looking forward to a game between Bialik High School and Chambly County for their second go-round. Reach for the Top is brought to you by the CBC and designed as a showcase for outstanding Canadian students. I'm Mark Cote saying be with us again in 7 days when more students meet to compete on Reach for the Top.
Most of the questions used on Reach for the Top are checked in the Encyclopedia Britannica.
From Studio 42 in Maison de Radio Canada, CBC proudly brings you the 1982-83 edition of Reach for the Top. Let's meet our competition now as we begin with a quick round of assigned questions.
And here's the first team. Laurie, Nyveen, name one of the two authors of the Communist Manifesto published in 1848.
Karl Marx.
Yes, the other was Frederick Engels. Lorne Beiles, what is the name for the repetition of a sound produced by the reflection of sound waves?
An echo.
Yes. David Tanenbaum, what is the term for a railroad with only one track running above or below the train?
Monorail.
Yes. Kenny Hechtman, what is the largest city in China in population?
Peking.
No, it's Shanghai. This is the team from Bialik High School in Cote St. Luke. And let's meet the other team, Ian Scott. In 1953, who was the first man to climb Mount Everest?
Sir Edmund Hillary.
Yes. Robert Riendo, what is an octogenarian?
Someone who's 80 years old.
Yes. Andrew Parkin, what is the name of Snoopy's bird friend?
Woodstock.
Yes, indeed. Gordon McPhee, which U.S. president's first name was Grover?
Cleveland.
Cleveland is right. This is the team from Flamborough County High School in St. Flamborough. These two high school teams are here to play the second semifinal game of the third league on Reach for the Top.
Welcome to the game in which some of Quebec's brightest students show their knowledge and power of quick recall as they strive to become the annual Montreal champions on Reach for the Top. Yeah! Hi, welcome to the game. I'm Mark Côté. Well, we've got a lot of spirit in the audience. We've got a lot of go in the teams for sure. They're veterans. They've been here before. They know what it's about. Bialik and Chambly County High School trying to get up there closer to the top, trying to make it to the finals of this third league. When all league finals are decided, of course, they play off at the end of the season to determine the annual Montreal champions. In studio with us to evaluate the answers, we have our judges. Both are CEGEP teachers. Here they are, Arnie Greenberg and Jackie Paul. And, of course, their rulings are final. Now let's meet the man with all the questions, your quiz master, Bob Cadman.
Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Mark Côté. Well, the teams brought mascots once again. Boy, do we have mascots and elaborate names they make up for them, too. Bialik brought one along, and that, believe it or not, is Yaakov Ben Bialik. That says Bialik in Hebrew on him. He's wearing a cap and gown. He just graduated. He got out before the students did. All right, down below, well, we've had a blessed event. That is Velen the Raggy Ramone, and she's given birth to Snuffy and Ronnie. Would you believe that? Okay, well, let's see if they can come up with some answers to some news questions for 10 points each. What municipal party has amassed, Andrew Parkin?
MCM.
No, amassed a debt of about $250,000. Bialik? David Tanenbaum.
MAG.
Yes, MAG, the Municipal Action Group. Name the La Presse sports editor who resigned, Lord Bayless.
Go by.
Yes, because he'd received $55,000 from the OIB. What award was won by Georgia Andrew Parkin?
Too much time.
Georgia running back Herschel Walker, Glenn Bayless.
Oh, it's the Heisman Award.
Yes, the Heisman Trophy, outstanding college player. What took place at the Club Chaperie and the Club Les Filles, Lauren Bayless?
There was the Strip-a-thon.
You've got it for the Tiny Tim Fund. Name the Quebec girl whose record release in Lauren Bayless.
La Pointe?
No, whose record release in September has sold 160,000. Gordon McPhee.
Natalie Simard.
Natalie Simard, you've got it. And that makes it Bialik 70, Chambly County 50. Now we have some stories that were news a long time ago. Questions about queens. Who is the daughter of Anne Boleyn and Henry VIII? Laurie Nyveen.
Elizabeth I.
Yes. What is the name of the Cunard ocean liner, now a floating museum, Kenny Hechtman?
Queen Elizabeth II.
No, a floating museum in Long Branch, California. Shelby County, your turn. Andrew Parkin.
Queen Mary.
Queen Mary. Who was Wonder Woman's mother? David Tanenbaum.
An Amazon.
You may be right, but that's not the name. Chambly County. All right, Andrew Parkin.
Queen Wonder.
Queen Wonder. Good try, but no, it's Queen Hippolyte. What is the term applied to the 1702 to 1713 North American phase of the War of the Spanish Succession, Lorne Nyveen?
Queen Anne's War.
That's it. And scramble for 5 points. What famous biblical hero was as a youth a musician in the court of David Tanenbaum?
David.
David, the court of King Saul, yes. So, a 40-point team question now for Bialik about biblical matters. Who was the son of Saul? He was befriended by David, and their names have since become synonymous with loyalty between friends. David Tanenbaum.
Jonathan.
Yes. The giant Goliath slain by David was a member of which enemy tribe of Israel? David Tanenbaum?
Oh, Philistine.
That's right. During his reign, David strengthened the kingdom of Israel as established by King Saul. How many tribes were under David's control? David.
10.
No, 12. Which one of David's sons stirred up a rebellion against his father and was later slain by the king's generals? David Hannibal.
Absalom.
Yes. It is now Bialik 125, Shelby County 60. From the Bible, we move now to mathematics. Listen carefully to these. What is the slope of the line y equals x? Laurie Nyveen.
Y over x?
No. Chambly County, Ian Scott.
Negative 1.
No, it is positive 1. What is the tangent of 90 degrees? Robert Rando.
0.
Judges, no. Bialik, Laurie Nyveen.
It's undefined.
It's undefined. There is none. What is the hypotenuse of a right-angled triangle with legs of 5 and 12 units? Laurie Nyveen.
13.
Right. What type of triangle has two sides of equal length? Andrew Parkin.
Isosceles.
Yes. What is the measure of the angles of an equilateral triangle, Andrew Parkin?
60 degrees.
You've got it. Here's a who am I question. 40 points wrapped up in this, dropping 10 points with each clue. I was born in the 10th century in Iceland, where my father, a Scandinavian leader, Andrew Parkin.
Leif Erikson.
Yes, for 40 points, you're right. Leif Erikson is right. The Viking who came to America. That makes it Bialik 145, Chambly County 120. Let me try you out now on a word question. Many words in the English language come from the names of places or persons. From these clues, you tell me what the word is. A humorous five-line verse that gets its name, David Tanenbaum.
Limerick.
Yes, from an Irish county. A word meaning to refuse to buy or use a product, named after Laurie Nyveen.
Boycott.
Boycott. This English army officer invented an artillery shell that explodes, David Tanenbaum. Too much time. Explodes in the air and scatters pellets over a large area, Shelby County. Nobody knows that is shrapnel. And there's the buzzer wrapping up this part of the show, and it is now Bialik 165, Shelby County 120. And before we take our break, we'll give you the list question. Both schools, acting as teams, must write down lists of answers to this question I'm going to give you. You've got 45 seconds during the break to make your list. The judges will collect your answers. You keep a copy, but they can't be changed after time is up. List the 5 states on the mainland of Australia. 5 points for each right answer. We'll be back to hear the list and have sights and sounds right after this. Don't go away. Well, the two teams are very close. They've been working hard on their lists. The question was, list the 5 states on the mainland of Australia. What did you get, Bialik? David Tanenbaum will tell us.
Queensland, New South Wales, Western Australia, Papua, and Victoria.
Well, we'll see whether you're right or not in a moment. Chambly County, Robert Riando, how about you?
Queensland, New South Wales, Western Australia, Southern Australia, and New Wales.
Okay, and the correct answers are Queensland, New South Wales, Victoria, South Australia, Western Australia. What are the scores they obtained, judges? 20 points apiece. 20 points for each team. Bialik 185, now Chambly County 140. Now we want you to watch your screen and watch the big screen here in the studio. Teams, sights, and sounds. Mr. and Mrs. is our first category. Identify these well-known couples. Who's that, David Tanenbaum?
Luke Carroll.
No, Chambly County, Gordon McPhee.
Arch and Edith Bunker.
No, it's not. It's Mr. and Mrs. Carroll O'Connor, the actor and his wife. These are all Mr. and Mrs. And what's this couple? David Tanenbaum.
Mr. and Mrs. Finch.
No, Chambly County. Andrew Parkin.
Mr. and Mrs. Anwar Sadat.
Yes. Here we go again. Another married couple, Lorne Beiles. Too much time. Chambly County, Ian Scott.
Mr. and Mrs. Astaire.
That's right, Fred Astaire. And how about them? Robert Miando.
Mr. and Mrs. Bob Newhart.
Yes. Here we go again. David Tanenbaum.
Mr. and Mrs.
No, too much time. Gordon McPhee.
Mr. and Mrs. Welk.
Yes, Lawrence Welk. And from another field, who's that, Andrew Parkin?
Mr. and Mrs. Walter Cronkite?
No, it's not. Bialik. David Tanenbaum.
Mr. and Mrs. Silverman?
No, Mr. and Mrs. Peter Lougheed from Alberta. And that makes, look at that score. Bialik 185, Chambly County 180. We've got an exciting game going here. They're almost neck and neck. Some music now. Identify the male singer performing each of these numbers. Who's this? Andrew Parkin.
Gordon Lightfoot.
No. Lauren Bayless.
John Denver.
No, it's Dan Fogelberg. There's a place in the world for a gambler. Who? Try this. Start on the tracks. Lauren Bayless.
Billy Joel.
Billy Joel. All for Lena. And this? Lauren Bayless. Too much time. Must know when you ring. That's the rule. Have to call time. Somebody pounded on the desk. You couldn't quite get it. It's Garland Jeffries, 96 Tears. Who is this? Dean Scott.
Rod Stewart.
Rod Stewart, Young Turks. And there's, once again, a five-point margin. An art question. Identify the painters who created these works with religious themes. This is by a Renaissance master of David Tanenbaum.
El Greco?
No. Chambly County, a master of many trades. Who painted it? Time is up. That was by Da Vinci, Madonna of the Rocks. This is by a Venetian master of light and shade, David Tanenbaum. He doesn't know. Painted this dramatic Miracle of St. Mark. Andrew Parkin.
Michelangelo?
No. Tintoretto. This English artist was also a fine poet, David Tanenbaum.
Gainsborough.
No. Chambly County? Andrew Parkin.
Wolf?
William Blake. And a stained glass window design by a famous David Tanenbaum.
Chagall.
Marc Chagall. And Bialik is 205, Chambly County 190. On your screen now, you're going to see some cars from years gone by. Identify these cars. It's coming there. Laurie Nyveen.
Cadillac?
Yes, it is. What would this one be? Lauren Bayless.
Rolls Royce.
No, Chambly County, Ian Scott.
Bugatti?
No, it's a Mercedes-Benz. All right, I want the exact car, David Tanenbaum.
Cobra.
No, Chambly County. Time is up. That was a Ford Pinto. And exact make again, Lauren Bayless.
Charger.
No, Chambly County, Ian Scott.
Tornado.
No, a Plymouth Duster. Yes, it was. What's this, Lauren Bayless?
Bugatti.
Too much time. Must know when you ring. Chambly County, Ian Scott.
Bugatti.
No, it's a Jaguar. And here we go again, Lauren Bayless.
That's a Rolls.
That's a Rolls Royce, yes. That's the end of our sights and sounds. Bialik 225, Chambly County 190.
Didn't get a flat tire, but we have a bit of a pause in the show, so let me tell you about prizes. To all of our contestants, we award the special Reach for the Top pin. Bronze for the first round, silver for league winners, gold for the annual Montreal champions. Look for these pins as the mark of an outstanding student. As well, to the winning school will go a $1,000 scholarship, possession of the CBC trophy for 1 year, and the right to represent the province of Quebec at the national finals of Reach for the Top, which will be played this year in Toronto. Yeah! Oh, we're not lacking for enthusiasm. To the runner-up team on the season goes a $500 prize. Now let's once more join the action, and back we go to Bob Catton.
Did you introduce me, Mark? I can hardly hear you with all this crowd here. All right, some news questions. 10 points apiece. Name the bulging-eyed comedian who died the rubber endo.
Marty Feldman.
Yes. Approximately how much money was raised recently on the Lorne Beiles?
$1 million.
No, on the Telethon of Stars, Ian Scott.
$1,600,000.
Right. This is a two-part question for 5 points each. Wayne Gretzky broke another record. What was the record, Lorne Beiles?
He got consecutive points in 29 games.
And you interrupted me, so can you tell me the other part?
He beat Guy Lafleur's record.
That's what we wanted. Name the American League batting champ for 1981, Lorne Beiles.
Reggie Jackson.
No, who was traded by the Red Sox to Oakland in a five-player deal, Champlain County. They don't know, Carney Lansford. The man once called the fastest in the world died, Andrew Parkin. He doesn't
Cole.
Know, died in Canada, Lorne Beiles.
Jerome.
Harry Jerome, yes. Bialik is 245, Champlain County 210. Only 35 points separating the two teams. Here's a scramble for five. Which one of Charles Dickens' characters is noted for the line, David Tanenbaum?
David Copperfield.
No. Please, sir, I want some more. Andrew Parkin?
Oliver Twist.
Oliver Twist. 40-point team question now for Champlain County. 10 points possible on each right answer, dealing with Oliver Twist. After his experience with the workhouse and the beetle Mr. Bumble, Oliver was apprenticed to a man named Mr. Sourberry. What was his profession? Andrew.
Undertaker.
Yes. On his arrival in London, Oliver met a young pickpocket in the service of the master thief Fagin. By what nickname, Ian Scott?
Artful Dodger.
Yes. Which character in the novel owned a bull terrier named Bullseye? Andrew.
Bill Sykes.
Yes. The thief... It's a tie now. The thief and housebreaker Bill Sykes later murdered the young girl who attempted to help Oliver escape from Fagin. What was her name? No prompting from the audience. Andrew.
Catherine.
No, it was Nancy. It is a tie. Bialik 245, Champlain County 245. What a game we've got going here. And now, movie versions of Shakespeare. In 1936, Norma Shearer and Leslie Howard starred in the screen version of which Shakespearean play, which was again filmed in 1968 with Leonard Whiting and Andrew Parkin?
Macbeth.
No, and Olivia Hussey. Bialik, Lorne Beiles.
The Tempest.
No, Romeo and Juliet. What was the title of the 1961 musical adaptation of Romeo and Juliet, set in New York, David Tenenbaum?
West Side Story.
Yes. Gene Simmons appeared in the 1948 film of Hamlet with which brooding actor in the title role? Ian Scott.
Laurence Olivier.
Yes. Olivier also directed and starred in what 1956, Andrew Parkin?
Hamlet.
No, what 1956 film about the ambitious Duke of Gloucester who becomes King of England? Bialik? David Tenenbaum.
Richard III.
Yes. Italian director Franco Zeffirelli produced his own version, David Tenenbaum.
Romeo and Juliet.
Not what we want. His own version of Shakespeare's The Taming of the Shrew with what famous couple in the lead roles, Champlain County? No prompting. Rob Grando.
Richard Burton, Elizabeth Taylor.
Yes, you've got it. And it's a tie again. Champlain County's caught up, 265 apiece. Biology now. A typical plant cell contains a nucleolus, chromosomes, and a nuclear, Lorne Beiles.
A nuclear membrane.
Not what we want. And a nuclear membrane in its nucleus. In which part of the nucleus would you find the DNA? Chambly County and Scott.
Nucleolus?
No, the chromosomes. What does DNA stand for, David Tenenbaum?
Deoxyribonucleic acid.
Yes. This is for one team only because there's only two possible answers. Which of the two nucleic acids is responsible for the role of protein synthesis? Lorne Beiles.
RNA.
Yes, it is. And it's about time for Sunday brunch, I think. I want you to identify these items you might find on a typical Sunday brunch menu. Many people like to start with champagne and orange juice or a concoction of vodka, tomato juice, and spices, David Tenenbaum.
Bloody Mary.
Yes. A popular item is made with poached eggs and a ham slice, Robert Riendo.
Eggs Benedict.
Yes. Some people would rather stick to lox and cream cheese on a, David Tenenbaum.
Bagel.
Not what we want on a bagel. What's lox, Chambly County? No prompting, Andrew Parkin.
Curd.
No, it's a kind of smoked salmon. And instead of bread, you might have rolls of puff pastry shaped into crescents, Lorne Beiles.
Croissants.
Yes. And you might order a beverage made of espresso coffee and frothed milk. It's made in, Lorne Beiles.
Cappuccino.
Yes, it is right. Bialik 315, Champlain County 275 now. We move on to a question about Canadiana, if we can hear. What Canadian crop has been described as the sumptuous spud, Andrew Parkin?
Potato.
Yes, the sumptuous spud from the rich red mud, Prince Edward Island potatoes. What long-famous jazz pianist was born... David Tanenbaum.
Gould.
No, born in Montreal, Gordon McPhee.
Oscar Peterson.
Oscar Peterson. What is the official flower of the Yukon? It has an affinity for fire-scarred earth, blooms even in the sub-Arctic, and Lorne Beiles.
Lichen?
No, and is rose-pink blossom, Chambly County, Andrew Parkin.
Snowdrop.
Fireweed. What 700-kilometer trail in Ontario was opened in 1967? David Tanenbaum.
Vermilion?
No, and is maintained entirely by volunteers. It runs from Niagara Falls to Tobermory, Chambly County. Andrew Parkin.
Hamilton Walk?
No, it's the Bruce Trail. And there's the buzzer winding up this part of the show. And the score now, Bialik 315, Chambly County 295. Well, we're going to have an exciting finish again. As you can see, 20 points between the two teams. Lots more points coming up on the short snappers, which will decide the game. We'll be right back after this. 20 points separate the teams as we go into the short snappers. Which of the Great Lakes is the only lake, Andrew Parkin?
Superior and Huron.
No,
Superior.
Only lake located entirely on
Lake Michigan.
Pardon?
Lake Michigan.
Yes, entirely in the U.S. Which American millionaire founded the Standard Oil Company, David Tanenbaum?
Arm and Hammer.
No, in 1882, Chambly County. Greg McPhee.
Getty.
No, John D. Rockefeller. What is the date of All Saints Day? Rod Randall.
October 31st.
No, Bialik. David Tanenbaum.
October 15th.
November 1st. Who followed Theodore Roosevelt as American president in 1909? Andrew Parkin? He doesn't know. Bialik? Taft. Time is up. It is Taft. The Sea of Marmora connects two larger, Laurie and Nyveen?
Black Sea Straits and Dardanelles.
Judges? No. Chambly County?
What's the question?
All right. We'll go on to the next one. What is the scientific term for the lower jawbone? David Tanenbaum.
Clavicle.
No. Chambly County? Rob Riando.
Mandible.
Yes. In Greek mythology, who killed the Minotaur? Rob Riando.
Perseus.
No. The Bialik? Kenny Hechtman.
Theseus.
Yes. The Seminole Indians are native to what American state, Laurie Nyveen?
Florida.
Florida. In which Shakespearean play do Miranda, Caliban, and Prospero, Andrew Parkin?
The Tempest.
The Tempest. After World War I, what did people call the stunt pilots, David Tanenbaum?
Barnstormers.
Yes. What do you call a tornado which occurs over a lake, David Tanenbaum?
Typhoon.
No, a lake or ocean, Chambly County. Andrew Parkin.
Ocean Twister.
No, a water spout. Next question. Zimbabwe is the new official name, Laurie Nyveen.
Rhodesia.
I couldn't hear you. Can't take it. And the game is over. The bell is gone. And the final score, Bialik 355, Chambly County 315. The winner, Bialik High School from Port St. Luke. Well, that was a really tight game and a good win for Bialik High School. Our congratulations to the team members, Laurie Nyveen, Lorne Beiles, David Tanenbaum, and Kenny Hechtman, and your team counselors, Mr. David Cape, Mr. Brian Wolofsky, Mr. Brian Katchen, and Mr. Harvey Levinson. Well, once again, there was a game that could have gone either way. Only 40 points between the teams at the end. Very close all the way. Chambly County from St. Lambert, you did very, very well indeed. Oh, I wish we could bring both teams back. They're so good. However, Bialik will be back. They move on. Our Cote will tell you about that in just a moment. We'll be back next week with another exciting game. Don't miss it. I'm Bob Cadman. So long till then. Mark, it's all yours.
Okay, so congratulations to Bialik. You're up one more step closer to the top. It was a close game. We love to have them both again, but we can't. Bialik and Malcolm Campbell will go at each other 7 days from now. Reach for the Top is brought to you by the CBC and designed as a showcase for outstanding Canadian students. We've seen 8 of them on display today. I'm hoping you'll be around in 7 days as more students meet to compete on Reach for the Top. Most of the questions used on Reach for the Top are checked in the Encyclopedia Britannica.
From Studio 42 in Maison de Radio Canada, CBC proudly brings you the 1982-83 edition of Reach for the Top. Let's meet our competitors for the first round of assigned questions.
And here's the first team, Laurie Nyveen. Who wrote the Moonlight Sonata?
Beethoven.
Right, Lauren Beiles. A recent Academy Award winner has won the Oscar three times for The Lion in Winter, Guess Who's Coming to Dinner, and on Golden Pond. Who is that?
Katharine Hepburn.
Yes, David Tanenbaum. Who founded Montreal?
De Maisonneuve.
Yes, Kenny Hechtman. Complete this saying, necessity is the mother of...
invention.
Indeed. This is the team from Bialik High School in Côte Saint-Luc. And here's the other team, Holden Huey. In which city would you find Sparks Street?
New York.
No, Ottawa. Gerry Moschopoulos. What two men discovered insulin?
Banting and Best.
Yes, Victor Sandor. Which British monarch ruled over Canada the longest, almost 64 years?
Queen Victoria.
Yes. Stephen Siamidis, Mysore is a state in what country?
United States.
No, India. This is the team from Malcolm Campbell High School in Montreal. These two high school teams are here to play the finals of the third league on Reach for the Top.
Welcome to the game in which some of Quebec's brightest students show their knowledge and power of quick recall as they strive to become the annual Montreal champions on Reach for the Top. Hi, and welcome to our game. I'm Mark Côté. As Bob has already mentioned, this is the final game of this third league. So we're getting close to the end of that season, and things are becoming very important indeed. These two teams should give us a good game. They're veterans. They've been here twice before this year. To help us evaluate their answers, we have in studio with us two judges. Both are CJEP teachers, Arnie Greenberg and Jackie Paul. And you guessed it, their decisions are final. Now let's meet the man with all the questions. Your quizmaster, Bob Cadman.
Right, thank you, Mark. Thank you, everybody. Well, we've seen mascots of all kinds on this program, but we have something really different this time. I'm not the only Bob on the program. One of the students, I think, may be arrested for having an offensive weapon in his possession, because that is Bob the Bialik Battle Axe. How about that? This is the school that also brings a wooden airplane from the Canadian Jewish Airline. Yes. All right. One small warning. When the students press their buttons today, it's going to sound a little different. Don't ask me why, but it's not going to be the old bell that we're used to. So you'll find out, and here we go. Some news questions for 10 points apiece. Name the millionaire politician, Lorne Beiles.
Pocklington.
No, who was recently charged with abducting his daughter, Malcolm Campbell, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Colin Thatcher.
That is right. The producer of the movie Gandhi was in Montreal, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Richard Attenborough.
Right. The Chinese Supreme Court has, Lorne Beiles.
Mao's widow's death sentence has been commuted. She can live now.
No, we want to know what her name is, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Jiang Jing.
That's right. One of Montreal's most popular radio, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Paul Reed.
Yes, he died recently. Actor Michael Bylan died, Lorne Beiles. He doesn't know. What character did he play, Gerry Moschopoulos?
E.T.
E.T. it is. And now the score is Malcolm Campbell 70, Bialik 40. And we have a question now about leaders in the world. With which country are or were the following world figures associated? Saddam, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Syria.
No, Saddam Hussein, Bialik, Lorne Beiles.
Jordan.
Iraq. Jose Napoleon, Gerry Moschopoulos. He doesn't know. Jose Napoleon Duarte, Bialik. Yes, Kenny Hechtman.
El Salvador.
Pardon me?
El Salvador.
That's right. General Wojciech Jaruzelski, Jerry.
Poland.
Yes. Deng Xiaoping, Gerry Moschopoulos.
China.
Yes. President Lorraine Nyveen.
Mexico.
No. President Stephen Siamidis.
Argentina.
Yes. Leopoldo Galtieri. And that makes it 100 for Malcolm Campbell, 50 for Bialik. let's have a scramble now for 5 points. What newsworthy event occurred at 4.03 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time on June 21st, 19... Gerry Moschopoulos. Time is up. He doesn't know. 1982, Bialik. All right, David Tanenbaum.
The space shuttle put its satellite into
orbit. No, it was the birth of Prince William of Wales. Nobody got it, so we'll go on to the next open question. A J question. People whose names begin with the letter J. Originally the wife of the Vicomte de Beauharnais, what attractive lady, Gerry Moschopoulos?
Josephine.
Josephine was the wife of Napoleon for 14 years. Al Jolson started the first talking motion, Gerry Moschopoulos.
The jazz singer.
Yes. During the latter half of the 1800s, which accomplished American novelist contrasted European and American society in such works as Portrait of a Lady, Kenny Hechtman?
Joyce.
No, and The Ambassadors, Malcolm Campbell. Time is up, that is Henry James. In 1215, John Lackland, King of England from 1167 to 1215, was forced to sign what important, Gerry Moschopoulos?
Magna Carta.
Yes, born on an Indian reserve near Brantford, Ontario, which Canadian, Gerry Moschopoulos?
Joseph Brant.
No, Canadian poetess was noted for her popular verse on Canadian patriotism and Indian traditions. Bialik, your turn. And David Tanenbaum?
Atwood.
No, Pauline Johnson. Which actress played Janis Joplin in the biographical, Gerry Moschopoulos? He doesn't know biographical film, The Rose. Bialik, Laurie, Nyveen.
Bette Midler.
Bette Midler, you've got it. What city am I? A 40-pointer, dropping 10 points with each clue I give you. Each team has one chance per clue. I am located on the site of Anfa, a prosperous town that the Portuguese destroyed in 1468. In 1515, I was resettled, Lorne, Beiles.
Madeira?
No, resettled under my present name, Malcolm Campbell. Victor Santor.
Lisbon?
No, second clue. I was almost destroyed by an earthquake in 1755, but was rebuilt 2 years later by David Tanenbaum.
Guatemala?
No, by Mohammed XIV. I am on the Atlantic Ocean. Malcolm Campbell's turn. All right, third clue then. Phosphates comprise 75% of my total export traffic. I handle 2/3 of Morocco's commerce. Anybody? Laurie Nyveen.
Spanish Morocco?
No, Malcolm Campbell, Stephen Simonis.
Casablanca?
Yes, for 20 points, Casablanca is right. And that makes it Malcolm Campbell 150, Bialik 60 points. And we have another scramble for you for 5 points. Which English mathematician is said to have discovered gravitation? Lorne Nyveen.
Newton.
Newton discovered gravitation, yes he did. And a 40-point team question for Bialik now about Newton's contributions to science. What did Newton invent that revolutionized the study of the cosmos? Bialik, your team question. And anybody want to try it? David.
Spectrometer.
No, the reflecting telescope. Not the telescope itself, but that particular kind. What is the property of matter which Newton's first law describes? They're figuring. David Tanenbaum?
Motion.
No, inertia. What is the product of mass and acceleration?
I got it.
David?
Force.
Yes. Newton's law of gravitation states that the force of gravitational attraction between two objects is inversely proportional to what? Yes, David.
The distance between them.
Judges? No, it's the square of the distance between the two objects. And now as the buzzer goes, it's Malcolm Campbell 150, Bialik 75. Well, Malcolm Campbell has the lead, but it's early yet. And before we go on to sights and sounds, we'll now have our list question. Now, the way this works is, I want each of these two teams, acting as a team, to write down a list of answers to the question I'm going to give them. You've got 45 seconds during the break to write down your answers, then the judges will collect them. And here it is. List the 5 cities which have teams in the Eastern Conference Atlantic Division of the NBA. 5 points for each correct answer, and we'll be back to get those answers right after this break. Don't go away.
But you have to have a job, Wembley. Life's not all fun and games.
And now a jobless Wembley has to do his Fraggle duty. Fraggle Rock tonight.
There's God, Peter.
Nobody at Gibson's wants Eddie.
Eddie, will you get lost?
Get out of my life once.
Eddie, why don't you check in with your Aunt May?
Get lost, kid!
So Eddie really does get lost. The Beachcombers, tonight.
Eddie!
Tomorrow on Hanging In, Kate must help a young girl break up with her boyfriend who has threatened to kill himself. Then it's the Paul Anka Show, MASH, and Newhart. George C. Scott uncovers a horrible secret in a house possessed.
That house is not fit to live in. Did you die in this house?
Mysterious forces seek revenge for murder. The Changeling, an award-winning premiere performance Thursday.
So now we'll find out what the answers are to those list questions. And first, David Tanenbaum for Bialik.
New York, New Jersey, Boston, Philadelphia, and Washington.
And we'll go down to Gerry Moschopoulos and Malcolm Campbell to find out his list.
Boston, Philadelphia, New York, Washington, New Jersey.
It looked good to me. Washington, Boston, New York, New Jersey, Philadelphia are the right answers. What's the score, judges? Yes, perfect score for both teams, 25 points apiece. Makes it, well, they haven't changed it yet, but it still stays a bit of a margin for Malcolm Campbell. All right, we'll go on to sights and sounds now, all 10 points apiece. And on your screen, you're going to see pictures of famous Canadian women. Tell me who they are. Jeremy Shoppless.
Anne Marie.
Right. And who is this lady? David Tanenbaum.
Jean Sauvé.
Yes, the Speaker of the House. Here we go again. Jeremy Shoppless.
Monique Bégin.
Too much time. Bialik, let's hear your answer. Lorne Beiles.
Jean Benoit.
I beg your pardon?
No,
it's Monique Bégin, Federal Cabinet Minister. Now, who's this? Jeremy Shoppless.
Too much
time. Must know when you ring. Bialik, Laurie Martin, Nyveen.
Maggie Trudeau. Okay.
Yes. Here we go again. David Tanenbaum.
Sophia Loren.
No, not exactly. Jeremy Shoppless.
Jacqueline Garreau.
Jacqueline Garreau, the marathon runner. And one more there, Jerry.
Adrian Clarkson.
Adrian Clarkson, formerly of the Fifth Estate.
Okay,
and now it is Malcolm Campbell, 205. Bialik, 120. Now let's listen to music from the films. Identify the movies from which these musical themes were taken. Here's the first one. Holden Huey.
Star Wars.
No. Bialik?
No.
Bialik, Lorne Beiles.
Empire Strikes Back.
The Empire Strikes Back, that's right. What film is this from? Yes, Stephen Simonis.
On Golden Pond.
No. Bialik? Lorne Beiles.
Tessa.
No, it's Somewhere in Time. Christopher Reeve starred in that. How about this movie? Lorne Beiles.
Midnight Express.
No, Malcolm Campbell. Victor Sandor.
Quest for Fire.
No, it's Altered States. And finally, a well-known film. Laurie Nyveen.
A Russian Winter.
No. Malcolm Campbell. Well, Victor.
Dr. Zhivago.
No, it's the Elephant Man. How about that? We have an art question now. Canadian artists, tell me which one of them painted each of these pictures. David Tanenbaum.
Jackson.
No, it's not. Malcolm Campbell, Jeremy Shoppless.
Harris.
No, Arthur Lismer. This next artist was born in England. David Tanenbaum.
Varley.
No, he was also a poet and was persuaded by Arthur Lismer to become a professional painter. Malcolm Campbell, have we seen it?
Yeah.
No, they don't know. All right, J.E.H. McDonald. This Canadian exhibited in the New York, David Tanenbaum.
Carr.
No, Malcolm Campbell. Jeremy Shoppless.
Harris.
No, David Milne. And this artist, born in Amsterdam, David Tanenbaum.
Krieghoff.
Cornelius Krieghoff, that's right. That makes it Malcolm Campbell, 205, Bialik, 140. You're going to see some famous buildings here on the screen. Tell me what these buildings are. There it comes. Stephen Simon.
United Nations building.
I couldn't hear you.
United Nations building.
That's right. The next one, please. David Tanenbaum.
Pentagon.
Yes. What about this one? Lorne Beiles?
It's Versailles, Paris.
No. Holden Huey.
Buckingham Palace.
That's it. What about this? Jeremy Shoppless.
St. Peter's.
Yes, it's St. Peter's of the Vatican. What about this? Jeremy Shoppless.
The White House.
Yes, and one more. Laurie Nyveen. He doesn't know. Jeremy Shoppless?
Shakespeare's House.
Yes, it is. And that's the end of our sights and sounds, and that makes the score now. Malcolm Campbell, 255. Bialik, 150.
Still trying to get used to those beeps and bops. I wish somebody just shoved them back into the Atari 400. In any event, while there's a bit of a break, let's tell you about prizes. To all of our contestants, we award a special Reach for the Top pin.
Bronze for the first round, silver for league winners, gold for the annual Montreal champions. And to the students from the winning school goes a $1,000 scholarship for their school, possession of the CBC trophy for 1 year, and the right to represent the province of Quebec at the national finals of Reach for the Top, which will be played this year in Toronto. And to the runner-up team on the season goes a $500 prize. Now let's get back to the questions. Here's Bob Cadman.
I think we'll delve into the news a little bit more here for 10 points each. A famous Hollywood movie director died, Gerry Moschopoulos.
George Cukor.
Yes. Name the Expo who's problem with drugs, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Tim Raines.
Tim Raines, signed again by the Expos. A man described as the winningest football coach, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Bear Bryant.
Yes, he died. Who was named... David Tanenbaum?
Gerry Moschopoulos.
Again?
He probably has been, but no. Who was named most valuable player, Steven Symetis?
Riggins.
Riggins in the Super Bowl. A Super Bowl record, 98-yard, David Tanenbaum.
Wolseley.
No, 98-yard kickoff return was achieved by what player, Jerry?
Fulton Walker.
That's it. We haven't had a spelling question for a while. We're going to have one right now. Some politicians have developed a colorful vocabulary. I want you to spell these words sometimes heard in the House of Commons. Well, I haven't started it yet, so we won't count that. So turn off Kenny's light, please, and here's the first word. Spell...
Goodbye.
All right, Laurie, I can't give you any more after you ring, so that has to be your turn. Obviously, you can't answer, and I'll give it to the other team. Spell exaggerate. Exaggerate, Malcolm Campbell. Anybody want to spell that on Malcolm Campbell? They're going to write it out first, while they're allowed to. Victor Sandor.
E-X-A-G-E-R-A-T-E.
No, there's two G's, I'm afraid, in that. All right, anybody spell flabber... David Tanenbaum.
F-L-A-B-B-E-R-G-A-S-T-E-D.
No, Malcolm Campbell, flabbergast. It is. You didn't let me finish it. Sorry. Colin Huey.
F-L-A-B-B-E-R-G-A-S-T.
That's it. Now try this one. Maybe a little harder. Hyperbole, David Tanenbaum.
H-Y-P-E-R-B-O-L-E.
That's it. Rhetoric, David Tanenbaum.
R-H-E-T-O-R-I-C.
And finally...
F-I-M-A-L-L-Y.
I won't count that, so turn his light off, and we'll go with gerrymander. Laurie Nyveen.
G-E-R-R-Y-M-A-N-D-E-R.
Was that right? Was it? Okay, gerrymander it is. And a question now on seagoing vessels. What kinds of boats or ships do these clues describe? A heavy square rig sailing vessel of the 15th, Laurie Nyveen.
Square rigger.
No, 15th to early 18th century, used mostly by the Spaniards. Gerry Moschopoulos.
Galleons?
Yes. A large ship that uses lug sails made of matting. David Tanenbaum?
Schooner?
No, and is common to the Orient. Malcolm Campbell, Holden Huey.
Junk?
Yes. Made of two separate hulls of equal size. Gerry Moschopoulos?
A catamaran.
Right. A large, fast, full-rig sailing ship developed by David Tanenbaum?
Schooner.
No, developed by American builders around 1840. Victor Sandor?
Laser?
No, it is a clipper. It is 345 for Malcolm Campbell, Bialik 180. And now scramble. Scramble for 5 points. What comic strip character is famous for crying? Gerry Moschopoulos.
Charlie Brown.
Well, judges, you got the right answer. It was just in time. I was going to say crying good grief, but he got the answer. So Malcolm Campbell, this is all about Peanuts for 40 points. Who created Peanuts? Vic Sandor.
Sherwood Schultz.
Again, please?
Schultz.
That is right. What character plays at fighting the Red Baron?
I'll take this game.
Gerry Moschopoulos?
Snoopy.
Yes. Who is Snoopy's secretary? Hold on to wait.
Woodstock.
Right. And who is Lucy's brother? Gerry?
Linus.
Linus. Yes, indeed. We have some tall buildings. We're not going to show them to you. We're going to describe them slightly.
Yes.
I want you to tell me the city in which each of these skyscrapers is located. All right, first of all, the 110-story... Kenny Hechtman.
New York.
No, the Sears Tower, Stephen Symetis.
Chicago.
Right. This is in a Canadian city, the 30... David Tanenbaum.
Toronto.
No, the 32-story Harbor Center, Malcolm Campbell. Victor Sandor.
Vancouver.
Pardon?
Vancouver.
Yes. The 48-story Transamerica Pyramid, Gerry Moschopoulos.
San Francisco.
Right. And the 77-story Chrysler Building, Gerry Moschopoulos.
Detroit.
No, Bialik. David Tanenbaum.
New York.
New York. Oh, okay. You got it. Now some math for you. Okay. Find the least common multiple of the following. 1, 2, and 3. Gerry?
6.
That's not too hard, yes. 2, 3, and 6. Lorne, Nyveen.
12.
No, Malcolm Campbell, Victor Sandor.
6.
6 it is, no prompting from the audience. 3, 4, and 5. Gerry?
60.
Yes. 2, 4, and 6. David Tanenbaum.
11.
No, it's not. Malcolm Campbell, Victor Sandor.
12.
12. 3, 5, and 7. David Tanenbaum.
15.
No, Malcolm Campbell. Gerry?
105.
47.
Again?
105.
That is it. And now scramble for 5 points. Thompson, Manitoba, and Sudbury, Ontario. Gerry Moschopoulos.
Nickel.
No, are important sites of what major Canadian industry, Bialik? Lauren Beiles.
Nickel mines.
Well, it is mining. Judges, what about that? All right, close enough, we'll take it. Bialik, a 40-point team question for you, all about mining in Canada. Which immense physical feature covering much of Ontario and Quebec is composed of hard rock rich in valuable minerals? David.
Canadian Shield.
Yes. In 1896, gold was discovered. Oh, there's the buzzer winding up as part of the show. And the score right now is Malcolm Campbell, 480, Bialik, 205. But it's not over yet. We still have the short snappers coming up, and we'll have them in just a moment, right after this break.
Canada's young athletes in action, the ultimate challenge. Watch daily coverage of Canada Games 83, weekdays at 5, 5:30 in Newfoundland. Two West Coast artists, two styles. Tony Onley.
You know, it's been 600 years since Leonardo da Vinci first thought of the idea of flying. And I see no reason why another artist shouldn't pick it up.
And Gordon Smith.
I store all these images up because I'm surrounded by this landscape.
Portraits, Wednesday.
If you're planning a trip to the United States, Latin America, Eastern Europe or Western Europe, or even Africa or the Caribbean, why not take us along? Radio Canada International, and keep in touch by shortwave. For a free program schedule, call or write your nearest CBC station. Radio Canada International, a friendly voice from home.
For the poor of Bangladesh, there are no 8-hour days and no 5-day weeks. Every day, millions of people work long hours for little return. Women and children break bricks for road construction. And boys struggle behind the plow, unable to attend school. But with your support, the USC helps workers to produce and earn more. USC loans to landless laborers double food production. Vital in Bangladesh, where millions are still hungry. The USC provides clean water to reduce disease, instructs children, trains women in crafts to help support their families, and teaches nutrition, hygiene, and family planning. Help the USC, help men like these make the soil produce. They want to work, they can produce. Please help through the USC, 56 Spark Street, Ottawa.
Now the short snappers, and they're all 10 points apiece. In chemistry, the emission of a beta particle results in what change in mass and atomic number, David Tanenbaum? It
lowers an electron.
No, Malcolm Campbell, Victor Sandor.
It lowers the mass by 2.
No, there is no change. What is the term for a ditch surrounding a castle? Lorne Nyveen.
Moat.
Yes. What is the term for change in the velocity of a body divided by the... Gerry Moschopoulos.
Acceleration.
Yes, it is. What is the molten rock? Turn Lauren's light off. What is the molten, David Tanenbaum?
Lava.
No, the molten rock from which igneous rocks are formed, Malcolm Campbell. Nobody knows that is magma. The best caviar is prepared from the eggs, David Tanenbaum?
Sturgeon.
Yes. What planet has a satellite called David Tanenbaum?
Jupiter.
No, a satellite called David Tanenbaum? No, called Triton, Malcolm Campbell. Gerry?
Neptune.
Yes. For what sport did the ancient Greeks build Gerry Moschopoulos?
Track and field.
Build hippodromes, Bialik. Lorne Nyveen.
Horse racing.
Yes. At what time of day do all Jewish festivals begin, David Tanenbaum?
Sundown.
Yes. To what special category do the following hunting dogs belong? Afghan, Beagle, and Whippet, Lorne Bayless.
Hounds.
Yes. What Canadian author wrote the novel Cabbage Town, Gerry Moschopoulos?
Leacock.
No, Bialik. David Tanenbaum.
Mordechai Richler.
No, Hugh Garner. In what 1920 film did Ronald Reagan portray David Tanenbaum?
Bedtime for Bonzo.
Not exactly, no. Portray football star George Gipp. Jeremy Schopoulos.
Newt Rockne, All-American.
You've got it. In what country were people of noble family called boyars? Lorne Beiles.
Russia.
Yes. What turbojet aircraft introduced by Lorne Beiles?
747.
No, by Air Canada in 1966, carries 95 passengers. This is for Malcolm Campbell.
Who cares?
Stephen Simons.
Challenger.
I couldn't hear you.
The Challenger.
No, it's the DC-9, and the bell has gone to end the program, and the final score, Malcolm Campbell, 500, Bialik, 265. The champion of the third league is Malcolm Campbell High School. Well, once again, Malcolm Campbell put on a fine performance. You have reached the top in the third league. Our congratulations to the team members, Holden Huey, Gerry Moschopoulos, Victor Sandor, and Stephen Siamidis. And your team counselors, Mr. Philip Spink and Mr. Gary Eng. Well, Bialik, you did very well, too. You've done very well all through the season. You came up against a very strong team here today, but we liked having you with us. Let's have a great hand now for Bialik High School from Coach St. Luke. So, once again, we've declared a league winner, and we'll start a new league next week with another exciting game. I'm Bob Cadman. Hope you'll join us then. Mark Cote, take it away.
Well, congratulations to you, Malcolm Campbell, as you continue, and force me to, reach for the top. There you go. We'll see them again 9 weeks from today when they start competing in the year semifinal. Reach for the Top is brought to you by the CBC and is designed as a showcase for outstanding Canadian students. I'm Mark Cote, inviting you to be with us in 7 days when more students meet to compete on Reach for the Top. Most of the questions used on Reach for the Top are checked in the Encyclopedia Britannica.
CBC serving Quebec.